Alright, hello there. I'm Popo1 and this is SmackDown vs. Raw 2007. And we are doing the 16-team 3v3 Tornado Tag Elimination Tournament. So this will be the final part of the round of 16. And we scroll down here, these will be the last three matches. So we're going to be doing it's eight matches, so yeah, this is match 6, 7, and 8.
Yeah.
All right. So without further ado, we can go into the game. Where you got the first match set up? All right. Going here and basically get started. Again, we'll have the stamina system turned on, so you don't got to worry about them slowing down and going in there. Now, I have the KO turn on, and it's especially turned on for this elimination tag match because let's say you're down 3-1, which was the last match, and somebody made a 3-1 comeback, you know, by KOing the people. Because if there's somebody getting KO'd, that means they're just automatically eliminated. Versus if you have to win by pinfall or submission, that could be broken up.
KO can be broken up.
And I fell asleep during it because I was like, should I do this match or should I just go to bed right now? And I ended up falling asleep. But that was because I stayed up past 30 hours, I think. But shoot, I was already up for over 24 plus hours, but it's because I was laying down.
Wait.
Where is it? This? So we need for the performance to be. Alright, cool. Now that way the performance would be better on this. Alright, that's right. Oh, only thing I gotta do is disable this. Okay. Something else to speed it up a little. No, that's the beat.
Thank you.
SmackDown versus Raw. I mean, not SmackDown versus Raw, my bad, but Here Comes the Pain. SmackDown versus Raw 2011, you had a lot of them that you could have and stuff like that. Like, I think you can have an infinite amount of finishers and stuff on there, but I think five is enough. Especially where you can also start off with five of them and then Here Comes the Pain and shut your mouth. Is it three or four for just bring it? What does that know your role? Anyway, I like the ones where like you can store them and you get up to five, because it's gonna take a while before you get up to five anyway. Oh shit, you know, but you gotta start off with them. I wish that was an option. Superplex from the second rope versus going all the way to the top rope to do the superplex. I mean, if you're going to do a delayed superplex, you got to do it from the second rope. Gonna be hard to beat. Let's go here. So, why is called Perfect Destruction. Instead of Brothers Destruction, a name for them will be Perfect Destruction. Or the Annihilation. So it's gonna be Chavo, Kid Cass, Gregory Helms, JBO, Wilm Wrinkle, and Finley. Alright. Another thing is like when you select in tag teams and stuff, they don't let you select all of one team first. You gotta select them side by side. Which that's good. He basically hired them, JBO. Oh yeah, Gregory. Machismo. That was such a racist thing to say. I think it was said. No, he said that to Rey Mysterio, not Eddie Guerrero. He said that to Rey Mysterio. Machismo. Alright, we can start. I think that would have done a little bit more damage to Kid Chaos, because I think that's one of JBL's finishers, isn't it? The powerbomb? Like, back when he was when he first became JBL and stuff like that, or changed his name to JBL, one of his moves was the powerbomb. Now his body is getting hurt buddy's clinch knees. He's just low blowing everybody. Yo, a team of heels would probably end up winning this. I did have a thing where I was talking about I will set everybody to heel or something depending on what type of match it is, but I just let them be wherever the heck they are. If they're a heel, they're a heel. If they're a baby face, they're a baby face. I could care less. JBL's in the surfboard by Kid Cash. Power of the punch, he just hit him with the brass knuckles. The Kid Cash got his finisher, so that's why he didn't stay down for long. Nice back pressure right there. Regal would probably be the most obvious choice for their team to try to take out, since he's one of the more injured people and stuff like that. I suggest, yo, if this game had the AI being super smart, you'll see Kid Cash hit the freaking brain buster finisher. Then you'll see freaking Gregory Helms hit the shining wizard, and then you'll see freaking Chavo Guerrero hit the frog splash in that order to take out somebody and stuff like that. Three men on finishers that all set up each other, you know? You'll see Fiddly use the air raid crash, and then, but JBL makes him get back up so he can hit the clothesline from hell, and then William Ringo will finish him off with the legal stretch. I wonder, does he get the regal plex in this game? The power of the fist. I mean, power of the punch. The brass knuckle. How's that legal? How's that illegal? My bad. It's like, how's that legal? Of course it's not legal. Yo, so he gets reprimanded for using his finisher? That's messed up. So in a match, he could be close to getting a three count, but the referee is like, hey, is that brass knuckles? Uh-oh, Kid Cash with the brain buster. Oh, no, he didn't get the strip. He's trying to hit his brain buster. Oh, no. So, this game is different. If you ain't got the strength to pick the person up, you're not going to be able to pick them up. And I don't think that is because Kid Cash can't pick up Will Regal. I think it's because he's injured, so they ain't not letting him pick him up. Is that how this game works? That you have to have good health to pick somebody up? But he should still be able to pick him up because he got better health than Will Regal. Swinging neck breaker. They got a KO one Rico for they can get this 201 situation going. Because Rio is just going to keep going. Uh-oh. That time he was able to get it. Going for the brain buster. I think he just KO'd him. I think Reno Rigo is out. He just got KO'd. And that referee is bogus, man. Oh, wait. He's already watching the submission game going on right now. Oh, that was going to finish him. He was closer to escape than anything. They accidentally hit each other now. Shining Wizard. No, that probably ain't going to take out JBL. It could possibly take him out. JBL is still pretty healthy in the ring. Finley is kind of as well. Chavo Guerrero just keep on hitting people with that finisher, man. Yo, nothing's harming him. That's crazy. He got drop kicked in the back and everything. I like the way the size difference is playing a factor in this game right now, because, like, oh my goodness, he finna hit him with another one of those? I forget what the heck that's called. Oh, it's not gonna work. Now, I'm not sure if that's the size difference playing a factor or the fact that he's... Oh, that chop. He didn't mean to chop him, but he did. Look at that. The Cruiserweights are about to beat Finley, William Regal, and freaking JBL. Wow. That was an underdog team too, man. We got some upsets. That freaking brainbuster. I see how all those stuff have been going on. Now we'll take a closer look at everything once we get done with the final match. So we have Matt Hardy, Mr. Kennedy, and Trevor Murdoch versus Eddie Guerrero, Rey Mysterio, and Batista. Normally that's how you do it. Kennedy. Oh. I know I got Matt Hardy, Eddie Guerrero, Mr. Kennedy. Alright. Let's go back on here. Matt Hardy, Kennedy, and Trevor may be like people that I just threw together, but they seem like they'll be a random tag team that somebody will put up against somebody. And like Eddie, Ray, and freaking Batista. Did they ever do a three-man team match against somebody before? Because I know Batista's been tag champ with, I believe, Ray. Because I think they beat Eminem to become the tag team champions. But did him and Eddie ever become tag team champions? Because they had the, you know, they had like the rivalry thing where they became friends and stuff, where it was, you know, Eddie tried to go after Batista's title, but he was trying not to be a heel about it. It just came off weird because he was like, you're waiting for the betrayal, but he just never did it. I was like, okay. So that was a thing. But what was the other thing? Too, like vertical suplexes and stuff like that, you could pick up anybody with it for some reason in that game. Like vertical suplexes and a couple other things, you could just pick up anybody with it. It won't do the super heavyweight versus something else when you do that type of stuff. You can hit the snap suplex on anybody.
Yeah!
So you gotta take out Batista first. You know, I was wrong to say you need to take out Rey Mysterio first. It should be Batista. Nah, Rey is still in it. Oh, because he had his finisher. That's why he survived. He could have reversed it or get out of it. What'd you cheer for, Eddie? It was like when you and what's the name, Mr. Kitty was the first ones out of here. Never mind. Him and Mr. Kitty got eliminated the first at the same time. It was what's the name was the first one eliminated? Matt Hardy. Yeah, that's right. That's how all that went down. We did it, Holmes. Like you did not. Why you up there? What are you doing? I just like the fact that who knows who's gonna win with this stuff, because if this was Here Comes the Pain, the team with the higher ratings just automatically win. That's the reason I'm probably going to make my own characters on here. I'm going to continue. I'm not sure when I'm going to make another character for the superhero characters or something like that for Here Comes the Pain. But as far as this goes, I'm probably just be making my own character for SmackDown vs. Raw 2007. Alright, so let's recap everything.
So, Bobby Lashley and Shelton Benjamin and Mark Henry beat the Foleys, Mick Foley, Cactus Jack, and Dude Love. Team Canada, which consists of, I can't even call them Team Canada. Well, the Hart Dudgeon alumni of Bret Hart, Jimmy Nadal, Nari Hart, and Edge, they beat Kurt Angle, Chris Benoit, and Taz.
Because I can't call them Team Canada when Chris Benoit is from Canada. That makes no sense. It's like, why was he part of Canada? You know? Because Edge changed in the Hart Dudgeon. Did freaking Chris Benoit change there? I know that Lance Storm and Chris Jericho trained there. I'm pretty sure that Chris Benoit maybe have trained there. He may have trained there, but I know for sure it was Christian. I'm not sure Christian. I know that Edge did. And I know that Chris Jericho and Lance Storm did as well. But I'm not sure about Benoit. He had to train there.
He had to train there. Or was he already... Because him and Eddie Guerrero was already wrestling in, I think, Japan before Chris Jericho. Or no, they was all wrestling there around the same time. Yeah, because Jericho's name was Lionheart, which he also used as his name when he was in ECW. And Benoit was White Pegasus. And Eddie Guerrero, I think he was Black Tiger Mask number two or something like that. He was either, I don't think he was one. He had to be two. I forget who was one, but he had to be number two when he was over there. He could possibly have been number one, but I think he was number two. Anyway, we got Roddy Piper, Stone Cold, and Randy Orton, and they lost to... I call them the Kiss-Ass. No, I'm just playing. Hulk Hogan, The Rock, and John Cena, you know. Or, a better name is Corporate Stooges. You know, they're like
the face of the company. Even though Stone Cold was the face in his and Rock's era. You know, he's the one that put Rock over. But, because they were both the same. Like, it was equal with Stone Cold and The Rock. With their stuff, I want to say the same thing with Roddy Piper and Hulk Hogan, but Roddy Piper was more so the antagonist to like the Hulk and a lot of other people and stuff like that. I'm not sure how, because it was also Jake the Snake Roberts as well, yeah, over there and stuff like that. Those two were like the main antagonists of everybody and stuff like that. Randy Orton, John Cena. Randy Orton, majority of the time, was the heel. Well, he was, compared to Jesse, he was always the heel. Okay, yeah. But yeah, they won. Carlito, Chris Masters, and Snitsky, they lost to the hardcore legends of Mankind, Hardcore Harley, and, what's the name, RVD. Now, the reason that I put Mankind over here with Foley, Cactus Jack, and Do Love, because I was gonna put Cactus Jack over here with Hardcore Harley and RVD, but I decided just to leave him where he was at, because Cactus Jack and aren't really Cactus Jack and what's the name, Mankind, are really like his most dangerous personas and stuff like that, like the Hell in a Cell matches, everything that he did in Japan and ECW, that was with Cactus Jack. Well, the later part of his career was he doing like the hardcore stuff again when he was Mick Foley and stuff, but that was pretty much towards the end of his career with that stuff, but he was still putting on some banger matches and stuff. Yeah, Do Love, I forget where he was Do Love at.
Totally forget.
I just think of that as a mistake. I think of that whole era thing as a mistake. We just Do Love. We got Triple H, HBK, and Ric Flair. And this is the one I was talking about when I said somebody made a 3-1 comeback. And it was Big Show, Super Crazy, and Dusty Rhodes. And I literally made them at the last second. I was like, you know what? Because I had Big Show. It was
Big Show, Shane McMahon, and Jerry the King Lawler. Because, you know, he's always cheering for Vince McMahon versus JR, who's not cheering for Vince McMahon and stuff like that. So I was like, he would want to be on Shane McMahon's team. But then I was like, you know what? Nah, I can scratch them off. I did want to keep Jerry the King Lawler, but I was like, no, I'll put it to the side, because, like, you know, he's basically retired on commentary and stuff. And, like, how would that look? Him being the match that he's commentating, he's going to be so biased on commentary because he's commentating for himself. He's like, look at the greatest superstar ever to ever be
step foot in WWE ring. That's what he'll be like. So, yeah, that's why we changed it to Super Crazy, and then I was like, who else to put in there? I was going to put Psychosis in there, but I was like, you know what? I'll put Dusty Rose in there, you know? So that's why we put Dusty Rose in there, Super Crazy. Because it was going to be Super Crazy Psychosis. But the thing is, Big Show did it by himself. It was 3-1, and he basically eliminated Shawn Michaels and HBK via chokeslam KO, and then he eliminated Ric Flair. I forget how he eliminated Ric Flair. And that was snoring. Like, literally once the match is over, you know, they do little pose and stuff. Like, the sound cuts off for a second, and you can literally hear me snore for a few seconds at the end of, like, the 42 or 43 minute or something like that. And that's why I had to cut it out, because the video went over an hour and 20 minutes. So that was basically just well over a half an hour of, like, the phone not doing nothing. So I learned how to do this on the fly. Let me show you real quick. The edit thing. I edit the video and stuff like that. So I'm going to learn how to do that more and stuff like that, because you can also add stuff. So, like, let's just go to a random video. No, I don't want to accidentally do nothing with that stuff. What other videos could I do that stuff potentially with? Oh, yeah, I got stuff on here that I could possibly do that stuff with. Oh, wait, no, it won't mess up even if I do that. So, yeah, I could have picked anything. Right? So you see how this video is, what, 5 seconds. Cool. I could cut this if I wanted to. Oh, it changes the thing to that. So I could basically trim the video down. I could trim the video down to this and this. Right? And it says trim the video. So that's 2 seconds of that same video. Like, we can go out of this and we can go out of everything and, like, see? It's 2 seconds of the same exact thing. See, that's the whole 5 seconds. And this trimmed down to 2 seconds. So I could keep both. That's the cool thing about it. You can keep both. And I think also on there, I could add something to the beginning of it, which I didn't realize I could do. Wait, is this the 5 seconds? Yeah, this is. No, I'm not gonna do nothing to it. I'm gonna delete the one I just made and stuff. That's just where we could quickly look at what it does. So that's what I basically did. And you can also just trim the beginning part if you want to, because you don't have to. You could just trim the ending or the beginning part if you want to and stuff. So that's what I had did, because I get rid of the snoring per se, but I got rid of the last fucking 30 minutes of it. That shit took, it took probably about 10 or 15 minutes, because it was 40, it was creating the video and it was over 42 or 43 minutes. So it had to redo all that stuff. So that's how that happened. So that's what happened to part two. Because part one was basically the first two matches. Part two was the next three matches, and then you just saw me do the final part, which was part three, was the last three matches and stuff like that. Yeah. So let me see. I'm gonna go like that, then go like that. This is just so I can know which ones to freaking do stuff for easier. Stuff like that. And I guess I can put the exits on. No! We don't really need to put the X's anywhere, but I'll put them on there anyway. Yeah, it's just a better way to keep up with what's going on the screen and stuff. So we'll put the X right here. We'll put the X right there. Because I don't accidentally, I just try to make sure I don't accidentally do nothing I'm not supposed to. Man, these next rounds, who's going to win? I believe Bobby Lashley, Shelton Benjamin, and Mark Henry could possibly take that match, too. Because Mark Henry is a super heavyweight. And I think, yeah, the Jim the Anvil, Jim the, what's it called? No. Nightheart. Yeah, Nightheart. That's what it's called. Jim Anvil Nightheart. Yeah. I was wondering why I was struggling with his last name, because I said Nathal, and I was like, no, that's not, it's supposed to be Anvil. Yeah. But he's just a regular heavyweight, I believe. And Mark Henry's a super, super heavyweight. 400 pounds and stuff. So that's going to be a problem for them. And the champions are kicking out 2.9. They probably gonna beat Mankind, Marco Hardy, and RVD.
They gonna need Alabama Slammers and freaking 5-star Froth Flashes back to back. Mankind can hit his what's it called? Mankind can hit his double arm DDT and then go for the mandible claw and stuff, but like, he's gonna need the other people to be occupied to hit that mandible claw to get finished, cause he could possibly finish somebody with that. And what we got, another super heavyweight, Big Show teaming with Super Crazy and Dusty Rhodes, but you got two big heavyweights. Or is it plus 300 pounds is super heavyweight or what? I gotta go see what exactly it was supposed to be for, like, super heavyweight. But we can. We can. Yeah.
No, I'm gonna set it up in a second. But yeah. Yeah, it don't matter. Yeah, anyway, this is gonna end the video. This was the final part of the round of 16. Hope you enjoyed all the matches and stuff like that. And to the next one later, and hope you enjoy. As crazy as heck that, like, over the years, there's so many people who was over 400 pounds, but for whatever reason, this game stops people weight class at 400 pounds, because Viscerar was 550 or something like that when he was wrestling. And I think Yokozuna had to be damn near 600, I think, or he was about the same and stuff like that. Big Show at one point was, I wouldn't say he was 500 per se, but he was at least 480 or 450. No, his heaviest, he was probably like 480 or damn near 500 pounds. Because I forget what type of injury or what was going on with him. But like, when he was with ECW, he just looked super out of shape. So he had to be at least 480 or something like that during that time period. Then he came back and he was down to at least 430 or 440 or something. You know, he came back and he started hitting people with the WMD, the Weapon of Mass Destruction Punch, or the KO Punch, which they later called it. Yeah, it don't matter. To the next one later, and hope you enjoy.